Look, guys, I'm Yatinjit Kaur and I'm in a fourth year. Plus, also, I'm a tutor at Inspiring Minds Coaching. So, here I'm with my new video on placenta. So, let's discuss about placenta. So, generally, what is placenta? In humans, it is generally the connection between the fetus and the mother. So, human placenta is generally discoid, hemichoridal, and deciduous. Now, what is the meaning of these three terms? Let's discuss in detail. Now, this discoid, because the shape of placenta is discoid. This is because of shape of the placenta. And hemichoridal, what is the meaning of the hemichoridal? Hemichoridal because generally the placenta have both maternal as well as the fetus part. Because of both maternal and fetal part. And deciduous, because why it is deciduous? Because after the delivery it also shed off. Because it sheds off after delivery. Now, generally, the placenta is, as I told you, the placenta is having the maternal part and the fetal part. So, the maternal part is what? It is known as the decidua bacillus, whereas the fetal part is known as the chorion frondosum. Now, just forget about this frondosum, just remember chorion. The chorion is nothing but it is a chronic villi. Okay, and generally this chorion is generally the smooth and glistery because it is covered by the amnion. And the maternal part, that is, as I told you, it is deciduous bacillus. It is generally rough pinkish in color, and it is generally the lobular in it is having the lobes. Generally it is having 15 to 20 lobes, and you know, the each functional unit of this lobe is known as the condyles. So just remember, it is a lobular surface which having 15 to 20 lobes. Okay, now generally, the battle-drawn placenta, I want to discuss about it. Generally, the placenta is having the umbilical cord in the center. So, if this is a placenta, you will see there is an insertion of the umbilical cord in the center. But when this umbilical cord is inserted at the margins, if it is like this, this is the umbilical cord, if it is inserted at the margins, then we call it as the battledore placenta, or also you can call it as a marginal placenta. So now the stroma of the placenta, it is generally the stroma of the placenta has the fetal macrophages, which are also known as the half power cells. So just remember it, the stroma of placenta has fetal macrophages. And the more about generally placenta at term, we will discuss first. Now, at term, when you see the diameter of the placenta, it is generally 15 to 20 centimeters. And if you measure the thickness of it, it is 2.5 centimeters and the weight is 500 gram. So about weight, I want to discuss. Generally, the birth weight to the placental weight ratio is equal to 6 is to 1 at birth. But if you're talking like at 17th, if you're talking about the 17th week, at 17th week, what you're going to see, the birth weight or ratio to the placental weight is 1 is to 1. So at 17th week, if you're talking about, just wait, I have to drop this. At 17th week, if you see the birth weight by placental ratio, placental weight ratio, it is equal to 1:1. Now what is the what does it mean? As I told you, birth weight at birth, the birth weight by placental weight is 6:1. Means if the fetus is having the weight of, you can say, 6 kg, then the weight of the placenta will be that in the ratio of 6:1. And at the 17th week, if the birth weight is by the placental weight ratio is 1:1, if the fetus is 1 kg at this week, so the weight of the placenta is like half of that, or is equal to that, like, or 500 gram weight of the fetus, then the placental weight is also 500 gram. Just remember this ratio. Now we will discuss about the placental formation. Now about placental formation. So if you are talking about the placental formation, it is by the primary villus, secondary villus and tertiary villus formation. So first we will discuss about the primary villi formation. Primary villi formation. Now this primary villi, generally it is formed at the 12th day, and it is also known, it is also solid villi, it is solid villi, also known as solid villi, plus it forms at 12th day. So just come to this figure, I want to discuss here some points. This green line that you are seeing here, that is nothing but this is a maternal part of the placenta, that is the decidua basalis. Just wait. This is the maternal part. And this white portion that all you are seeing here is nothing but it is the syncytial trophoblast. This is syncytial trophoblast and cyto. Generally the trophoblast, it divides into two things, the syncytial and the cytotrophoblast. So in the formation of placenta, for this just go for the embryology one. Generally for the formation of syncytial and cytotrophoblast, it divides into two. So this is a syncytial trophoblast, all the white I am showing here. And in syncytial trophoblast, you will see there is a one structure formed inside this, that is the lacuna, or this is the lacuna, the red one, or it is also known as the intervillous spaces. And this blue one that you are seeing here, this is a cytotrophoblast. These are nothing but these are the finger-like projections present. So this is all, these are all structure that are that forms a primary villi. So in primary villi, this are the structure. One first you will see, if you have to choose one, the options between the MCQs. So how is it is in, first is the decidua basalis, then it will form what, then syncytial trophoblast, then there is lacunae formation, and then you will see what, cytotrophoblast. So these are the structural arrangement of placenta in the primary villi formation. So and what else? Here you are seeing one artery. These are nothing but these are the spiral arteries from the maternal side. So these spiral artery will supply these lacunae and fill this lacunae with blood. So you are seeing here, there is a maternal blood inside these lacunae. Okay, so if they ask you the question, when is यूट्रो प्लस सेंट्रल सर्कुलेशन इज एस्टेब्लिश. सो वॉट इज योर आंसर? आई वॉन्ट यू टू आंसर एंड जस्ट पॉज दिस वीडियो एंड आंसर द क्वेश्चन. सो जर्नली दिस यूट्रो प्लस सेंट्रल सर्कुलेशन इज एस्टेब्लिश्ड एट 12th day, or you can say 12 to 15 days, because I told you the maternal circulation is from to the placenta is that when there is a primary villus formation. So generally the uterine placental circulation is established at 12th day. Now I will not rub this figure because I have to show you all secondary and tertiary over here. So now about the secondary villi formation. Secondary villi formation. Generally, the secondary villi forms at 16 to 17 days. It forms at 16 to 17th day. So what you're going to see here, just all the structures are same, just addition of one layer, that is nothing but this green layer. This is nothing but extra embryonic mesoderm. This is extra embryonic mesoderm. This structure is the structure of the secondary villus. Now about the tertiary villus. Tertiary villi, it forms at the 21st day. First day. So now in tertiary villi, there is the form. I will show you over here. There will be formation of the fetal arteries. These are the fetal capillaries. These are the fetal capillaries. So in tertiary villi, you will see the formation of the fetal capillaries. Now, if I ask you the question, when is the fetal placental circulation is established? So the answer will be at what day? At 21st day. So this is about the formation of placenta. Now we will discuss about the placental barriers. So placental barriers. Now just come over this picture and discuss. So generally the placental barrier is formed by the maternal blood and by these fetal capillaries. You can come over here. This is the maternal blood and the fetal capillary. This part is forming the barrier. So it is generally formed by what? Formed by maternal blood and fetal capillaries. Capillary endothelium. So now what are the structures that are included in the fetal barrier? So sorry, placental barrier. Placental barrier include the following structure. Now just come here. What are the structure you are seeing here? You will see this white part. That white part you are seeing here, that is syncytial trophoblast. So there will be what? There will be syncytial trophoblast. Now, what else? You are seeing this blue one, finger-like projection. What are they? It is a cytotrophoblast. So what you are going to see? That is cytotrophoblast. Then You are seeing this green line. So what is it? It is extraembryonic mesoderm. So other structure is extraembryonic mesoderm. And the last one is, you are seeing here, that is fetal capillary endothelium. That red line. So these are the main structure that are contributing in the formation of the placental barrier formation. So generally, what is happening to this syncytial trophoblast? This syncytial trophoblast will condense and it form one structure that is Nita-Bux fibroid layer. It is Nita-Bux fibroid layer. What is it? It is generally a layer that prevents the invasion of this trophoblast into the deciduous bacillus. So it prevents invasion of trophoblastic layer into decidua basalis. Now, if this layer is not formed, if this Nita-Bux fibroid layer is not formed, what is happening? If it is absent, then you will see the condition placenta accreta, increta and pancreta. So this the absence of this layer will leads to some very serious complications. About placenta accreta, increta, pancreta, I will discuss later in my next video. So now, what is the function of placenta? Now the function of placenta. So generally, it is helping in what? It helps in gaseous exchange of nutrients through maternal blood to the fetus, and it helps in a glucose transport. In general, a baby jo hota hai, wo glucose hi use karta hai as a source of energy. So maternal, that's why generally jo pregnant women hoti hai, wo always hypoglycemic hoti hai, because the baby is using the glucose as a major source of energy. And the placenta also helped in the lipid transport. It also helped in some hormonal transport. It also like having the immunological barrier formation, because IgG generally transfer hoti hai. So what are the functions? First is the exchange of nutrients, gases, lipid transfer, glucose transfer, some drugs are transferred, drug transportation. It also immunological function. And so these are some important function. Now I want to discuss one thing about the immunological function. Generally, fetus kya hai mother ke liye? It is just a foreign body for our body. So agar ye foreign body hai, toh why hamari jo body hai, wo isko as a foreign antigen recognize karke maar kyun nahi deti? So what is the answer of this question? Generally, there is a no HLA antigen over the syncytial trophoblast. That's why our body is not recognizing this fetus as a outsider thing. So in this immunological function, what is the main function of placenta? Because the syncytial trophoblast is having no HLA antigen, that's why our body can't recognize, will not be able to recognize it as a foreign antigen, hence the fetus will survive. Over syncytial trophoblast. So guys, this is all about the placenta. Thanks for watching my video. If you have any doubt, just comment in the comment section. I will try to answer your questions. And please subscribe our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram, and join our Telegram group. Thanks for watching the video.